Thank you, Andy. Del Boy, kind of get the feeling you're not a lover of these press conferences anymore. Eddie Hearn, pay me to talk. Oh, no. How much is that?
There is not.
No, you can't talk. That's a shame.
No. Guys, welcome back to my channel. If you've not done already, click the subscribe button and follow me across all my social media platforms. The links are in the description box below. Dereck Joseph Parker had a press conference today, so just tuning in today. Hopefully this is good. Hopefully it's not crazy like a couple of Dereck's previous press conferences, shall we say. But yeah, let's get started.
Been here many times. Huge fight for Joseph on Saturday night. Huge fight for you, as always. I know Mr. Chisora eventually shook your hand. He's quite hard to read, isn't he? But I promise you, he's a good guy underneath it all. But this is a massive fight for Joseph on Saturday after a very close fight last time. But this time, very different with a crowd.
Yeah.
And we expect a cracker.
Yeah, so first of all, I'd like to, you know, we're living in a pandemic, it's a crazy world, so the fact Matchroom Boxing are still making events happen, I'm in the event business, they're in a business where they could be told tomorrow there's no crowd permitted at the arena, so it's a risky business. So, you know, I think everyone in boxing, it's sometimes fashionable to hate successful people, but I think everyone in boxing should be grateful that Matchroom are keeping these shows going and providing these opportunities. And we're grateful, that's for sure, and grateful to Dereck Chisora for always bringing, you know, a fight. And, you know, someone asked me today, he's going to come swinging, trying to take Joseph's head off. Does that worry you? I said, no, it doesn't. I'm sure we're prepared for that. But secondly, I've seen Joseph sometimes at his best in those situations. You think back to when he put Dillian White down at the end of that fight, or in Joshua when the ref pulled him off, the dust-ups. And so I'm sure Joseph is going to be cool and stick to the plan, but if Dereck wants to swing, I'm sure Joseph's ready for that too. So, look, we're grateful to be here, and thank you again.
Obviously, a huge commitment from Joseph to fly over the other side of the world. He looks in tremendous shape with Andy. Now had a longer period to gel with his trainer. You know him personally as well, in a good space for this challenge.
Yeah, I think it's a zen camp. You know, I've seen all the camps and you know, they've prepared extremely well and had more time together. And there's just a steady calm that they know what the job is, so we're on the home straight. Now, and as for the commitment, Joseph and I actually don't know when we're allowed back home to New Zealand. So, yeah, definitely quite a commitment.
Well, I'm sure.
Why is that? Is it some sort of... Somebody let me know. Potentially some COVID regulations. But
New Zealand will be very concerned about not having your return, David.
We'll see. I might have to move in.
More than welcome.
Mow your lawn.
More than welcome. We've got a few mowers for you. The training teams, two tremendous trainers. I think one of the dynamics of this fight, which is so intriguing, is the two quality trainers that stand in hand of...
Alan Babish is a guy, man.
Of these two men, Dave Caldwell and Andy Lee. Dave, firstly for you, Dereck seems to be more committed the longer his career goes on. Is that something you've seen in this camp? Tony Bell, you always talks about staying up in Rotherham and how difficult that can be, but Derek's done it, looks in tremendous shape and ready to go on Saturday night.
I think as a fighter gets more experience under the belt, they get wiser, don't they? And they realise that certain mistakes they might have made earlier on in their career, they can't afford to make as they go on. They just learn, we just get smarter. And I think Dereck, when he linked up with David and the Haymaker setup, changed his way he lived, nutrition-wise, looking after his body, not abusing his body, and just keeping it, even in between fights, keeping it in maintenance and keeping it running really well. And I think that takes a, even though you can say, well, we're getting older, what happens there is that takes a length of time for it to really embed in. And with consistency, you get better results in how you perform. And right now, he's performing really, really well. I'm happy with the work that he's done in the gym. I'm happy with his commitment. As far as everything's concerned with myself, his sparring sessions have been great. He's in a really good place. And you'll see on Saturday.
What do you expect from Team Parker in this fight? Obviously, more time with Andy Lee.
Yeah.
I personally don't think this fight goes 12 rounds this time. I think they'll be, you know, keener to get...
My prediction will be coming out tomorrow, guys, and how I see this fight going. Yeah, stay tuned to that prediction. Tomorrow's video, you guys will see it. Let's go.
Get this one resolved without going to the judges' scorecards. I think the atmosphere in the arena, all those things that were perhaps lacking in that first fight. Is that what you expect, a fast pace in this fight and maybe not just to hear the final bell?
I don't expect it to go the distance. What, in answer to your question about Joseph, I think the link-up with Andy Lee, I've said numerous times, Andy Lee's a very, very smart man when it comes to boxing. He's worked with two of the best in the business, in Manny Sood and Adam Booth. Sprinkle a bit of Andy Lee's own knowledge himself and the way that he coaches himself, you're going to get results. And as he goes on and develops as a coach, he's going to get fantastic results as he goes on. So I'm expecting a better Joseph Parker. I'm expecting a more aggressive, positive Joseph Parker than we had in the first fight. He's got levers. He's got good balance. He's going to use it in an aggressive sort of manner. I don't think he's just going to look to go to the ropes and let Dereck bully him. It's going to be a better Parker. But the same vein is I'm expecting and I'm seeing a better Dereck Chisora. And Andy will say that he'll be expecting a better Chisora as well. You know, the thing when you go into rematches is when you've got intelligent fighters involved, they learn from the first fight. And Dereck knows that the shots that Joseph landed in the first fight, he can't afford those shots to land in the second because I expect him to be delivered with better technique. With better technique, they will hit harder. You know, and I'm expecting that. But there's mistakes that Dereck made in the first fight offensively that he won't make in this one. And you will see a better fight because both fighters will be better. And like you mentioned about the crowd as well.
Okay.
People, they've underestimated what a difference that makes to fighters like these guys with the crowd. Joseph's a massive name in New Zealand. He's always boxing in front of big crowds, big vociferous crowds, people behind him. Dereck loves the crowds singing his name, getting behind him. You know, there's certain fighters where it doesn't affect your cool, calculated boxing skillsters that'll think the way through, all the way through, everything's precise. Crowds don't really affect those sort of fighters. Fighters like Dereck, like Joseph, like your Conor Benz, people like that, they get that vibe and it adds an extra few percentages. And when you're talking about performance levels in these kind of fights, those little percentages add up.
Andy, do you share the common theme of this fight not going the distance that time around? I know you'll take victory by any means, but expect to be a lively encounter on Saturday.
Yeah, I agree with everything what Dave said. And I know how much Chisora will have improved with Dave, because when I won the world title, in my corner, assistant Adam Booth was Dave Caldwell. So I know all about him. And John Hill, by the way. So I know how he will help improve Dereck Chisora. And listen, to be honest, after the first fight, when the bell rang, I thought they were going to give the decision to Dereck Chisora, and I said it to him in the ring. I was completely honest. I said, "I think you probably won this." We got the decision, and when I watched it back, I thought Joe won the fight. And I would also agree with Dave that we won't be negative. Joe's going to be a lot more positive. He will stand a lot more and fight a lot more and be a lot more consistent with his attacks. It should make for an excellent fight.
If he's going to do that, and we know what Dereck Chisora is going to do, we expect a really great fight between these two on Saturday night in front of a big crowd again, which will make a big difference. It was difficult, wasn't it, behind closed doors? I mean, as a trainer, perhaps to get your fighter in the mode.
And you can hear all the voices, and if anything, the crowd being there will be a benefit to Chisora more than Joseph, because he will feed off that and the energy, and he's a big favourite. And it's like the old saying, you die a hero, you live long enough to become a villain. Which is, it's almost the reverse, where he's now the hero, and people love him, and they love his fight style, and he's given us great fights over the years, and great entertainment. But we're here to do business. It's all of this lamenting each other and praising each other, when Joseph gets in that ring, he'll be a different Joseph Parker in terms of the spite he has mentally and physically. And yeah, and I'll just finish off by saying cheer to the Makapunas at home, and we'll see you all Saturday night.
Thank you, Andy. Del Boy, kind of get the feeling you're not a lover of these press conferences anymore. Eddie Hearn, pay me to talk. Oh, no. how much is that?
There is not.
No, you can't talk. That's a shame.
No.
So you're going to put it on your phone?
No.
And you're not going to talk?
Anyone got a couple of...
All right, I'll go to Joseph.
Eddie
Joseph.
Yo.
Don't have to pay you to talk, do I?
No.
Dereck is mocking it. No.
Oh, good. Okay. Ready to go on Saturday night. You're looking in tremendous shape. Great camp.
Ready to go.
Expecting a tough Dereck Chisora on Saturday.
Yeah. Firstly, it's great to be back in Manchester with the team. Got Ben, Stephen, got Osman and Sonny Bill Williams at the back. Good to have you guys here. We've had a tremendous camp. A great camp. And this fight will be different to the first, for sure. 100%.
Andy talked about the crowd. I mean, I know you love fighting in front of crowds as well. You did it in front of 70,000 at the Millennium Stadium. You did it in front of 20,000 at the O2 as well. Weird last time? I mean, fighters get asked this question a lot, and some say, no, it made no difference, but I don't believe that to be true.
It made a big difference. I think the crowd, I know Dereck, he does feed off the crowd. I feed off the crowd too. A lot of fighters feed off the crowd, and just having no crowd, having no noise, hearing specific voices, it's pretty weird.
And finally, for you, I know that you're talking about a shot at the World Heavyweight Championship again. That is the aim for you, to become a two-time world champion. Do you need to put in an impressive performance? Scraping a victory on Saturday is not enough. You need to make a statement with this win.
Listen, the world titles are, you know, that's, my eyes are just purely on this weekend, Dereck Chisora. And I'm going to, you know, probably knock him out between round 6 and 10.
6 and 10. Okay.
Interesting.
Del, he said he's going to knock you out between 6 and 10.
What's going on?
I like the song.
Mama, that's enough of that.
That's a no from me.
We're not going to get any words from Dereck Chisora, but we're going to get a great fight on Saturday night, and we're going to get a great show.
Yeah,
finishing the year in style, live on DAZN around the world. Dereck Chisora against Joseph Parker, the rematch at Manchester Arena. Three other great championship fights as well. Of course, Jack Cullen against Sajo for the European title.
Yeah, man. Yeah, that. Listen, you've got to love Dereck at times. Yeah, he's. If he leaves the sport of boxing, he'll be very missed, in my opinion. I'll be just thinking, rah, bro, we need a Chisora presser. Yeah, that's the one thing we need. But big up to you guys. Tomorrow is the sort of fight preview and analysis of how I see the fight going, who I think's going to win, how I think the fight's going to go, 80 fixes and knockout. Yeah, stay tuned to tomorrow's video, okay? Stay tuned to tomorrow's video. I'm not going to give anything away, but let's just stay tuned. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. Peace, love, and prosperity. I will see you guys in a bit. Peace.